Come on in.
China may be big and filled with incredible sights, but it's not always the biggest things that are the most interesting.
Right, sometimes the most exciting sights right underneath your nose.
Shilihe is one of the biggest markets of its kind in the capital city of a country that's become a synonym for anything epic.
Which means it stands a pretty good chance of yielding what we're looking for today, some good old China style fun.
And a bargain, and this gives me the perfect chance to practice my haggling Chinese.
This is
150
a piece.
Can you give me a little
bit? It's cheap. I want
In Chinese medicine, you've got many meridians or pressure points all over the body, and there's several in the hands. So these are said to massage those and stimulate those meridians. It is quite soothing. Having your attention on doing something physical like this is actually quite calming and relaxing. Now check this out. Everyone's out to check out whether I made a fortune or not. Looking pretty fat, but it's really important that the other one is matching in size.
19.8，买的是130，现在卖掉，卖的话可以买300块钱。
Okay, so I just made some money. That's a good start of the day.
你这个盘怎么样啊？开的合同看这样可以。你收这里是怎么样？哇，这么漂亮！
See, look, this guy's got these nice round ones with nice symmetry.
早就开始玩了。早就开始玩。对，这是新买的。为什么爱玩这些东西了？就喜欢嘛。是吧？就是一块不错的，就是交流交流，看看。Shilihe
is what's known as a huanyao yuchong market, fish, bird, insects, and flowers, and there's about 30 of them in Beijing. Shilihe is the biggest, but as for China, goodness only knows how many there actually are.
People in China today have a lot more disposable income than they used to, but they're not just going to throw it away on anything. That's why places like this are super, super popular. People come down and get some antiques or a collector's item and just have fun.
This kind of thing is going to make you money. Oh, yeah, my lawyer. Nice. It's a kind of return that you get. The phrase that I said with this chap means making wise investments in times of peace, i.e. China's burgeoning economy right now, will turn to gold in times of war. It's a very ancient phrase, but basically it means buy wisely. And when you're buying something that's fun, well, smart fun, what could be better? One of the most interesting insights into a culture is seeing the differences in language. When we talk about having a good time in English, we often say fun, or leisure, or play. But in Chinese, there's one word that describes all these three things together and more, and that is 玩. In China, often people miss the countryside, especially the older generation, and so they buy crickets, take them home, hang them in their kitchen, and then they got the sound of the crickets in the countryside in their flat in the city.
吉祥，福寿，福寿
is like blessings, like riches, maybe financial, maybe health, and then so you got the shan, which is shanliang, which is kind. You got the hulu, which is blessing. So there's kind of a wordplay with all of the names of all the toys, I guess. These curios, I gotta call them curios as well. When we say fun in British culture, you could think of
a number of things,
loads of stuff. It just means anything and everything that makes you happy. But in China, we've learned today, fun means, basically, I'd say collector's items.
Yeah, I'd say so. I mean, all these old boys have come down with their friends. They're talking about their walnuts, their fans, discussing their jade, crickets.
Yeah.
Just anything. And we've been greeted with such kindness. People are willing to stop and have a chat with us, practice their Chinese with us. It's been great.
Yeah. Anything else you want to see, let us know. This is Morag. I'm David. Until next time, this is Open China.
Keep it open.
Keep it open.